Hello, welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. In this video I want to show how to make a water filtration system for a cabin or a camp, more of a kind of a semi-permanent camp. Okay, we checked out the water filters, the commercial varieties, and one in particular we looked at, it was $240. So we looked at the filters that it used, and it used Dalton ceramic water filter candle. So we went and bought the same filters ourselves. These are ceramic water filters, and I've probably got about $75 into this instead of $240. So I'll show you how I made it. We'll put it together. These filters we bought from Amazon.com. I bought three of them. Now, in all fairness, that water filter, the commercial one, had five of them. And five does no better job than three. It does no better job than one. It's just faster at filtering the water. Pretty self-explanatory when you look at the filters themselves, what size hole you need. Now, these are food grade buckets that I got from a catering service, a contractor service that takes care of remote camps and mines and oil platforms and whatnot. That's where I got it. Now, I ordered this spigot also from Amazon. Okay. The spigot, drilled a hole near the bottom, and we'll put the spigot in. Okay, here it is assembled, and I just finger tightened it. You don't want to finger tighten this nylon, or you don't want to tighten this nylon too much. You'll strip it out. It'll seal plenty well. Now, I cut the lid out for holes for the candle filters. Now, let's assemble the filters. As you can see, I cut holes in the bottom of the top bucket for the filters. Okay, you'll want to put the gasket on the top to seal the hole. Again, finger tightening should be just fine. Okay, and there we go. The water will go through the filter and come out these little holes, and it'll drip into the bottom bucket. There it is, assembled. Now, that cost just a fraction of the cost of a manufactured one.
Here's the filters that I got. They are a Dalton ceramic water filter candle. They are the Super Sterisil model 10-inch. Okay, and this is what they look like. These filters are used in manufactured expensive filter systems, to, you know, $200 and $300 systems. It's got a thumb nut on the end of it. And I also got a water spigot, a plastic water spigot, that I'll be using for the outlet of the fresh water, the filtered water. I got all of these. I got three of these filters and the spigot. So with shipping and everything, it's, I don't know, cost me $70-$75 instead of $200+, $300+. I got these from Amazon online. Okay, we've got our water. Went down to the lake and dipped it. This is typical water of Alaska, the interior of Alaska. It's what I call tea water. It's from the tannins. So let's filter it. See how it goes. They say you should run a complete cycle through this the first time you use it, and this is the first time we've used this. So there'll be charcoal that'll wash through from inside of these filters, wash through into the drinking water, the potable water. So you have to toss out that first batch. Okay, it's been a couple of minutes. The water didn't just pour. We'll let it drip through, and then we'll show you what it looks like after it's been filtered. We've been here for several days now using the water filtration system, and it works great. Like I said earlier, this is the Super Sterisil model of the Dalton ceramic filter line. It's the same exact filter that they use in a lot of professional manufactured water filtration systems. Portable filtration systems, you know, similar to this. And it's the same quality filter, same level of filter as is used in the Berkey water filters and other well-known professionally manufactured water filtration systems. Now, as far as how long this takes to drain through, I don't know. We didn't time it, and we keep adding here and there now and then. But basically, I guess, fill this up, and it's pretty much an overnight thing to filter it all down into here with the three candle filters that we're using. You saw, well, I'll show you how it works. You saw the water go in to the filter. It's what I call tea water, tea colored water. It's common in a lot of Alaska's interior lakes and rivers. I understand it's tannins. It's a vegetative matter that's been leached out of the plant materials and the musk eggs and whatnot. And the water filter system didn't filter it all out. It got some of it, but it's still a little bit yellowish, but it tastes fine. And this supposedly got out all of the cysts, all of the bacteria, all of the giardia, that sort of a thing that the professional manufactured water filtration systems get out.
because we're using the same exact filters. So the water tastes fine. So there you go. That's how you can build a cheap, not cheap, inexpensive water filtration system. It's a do-it-yourself thing for much, much cheaper than buying it new. Well, thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video. Hello, welcome to another video from Far North.